नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। माय नेम इज मनीषा सिंह। टुडे आई एम टीचिंग यू फाइटोकेमिकल एंड देयर यूजफुलनेस इन ओमेगा 3 फैटी एसिड्स। ओमेगा 3 फैटी एसिड्स आर प्रेजेंट इन फूड्स एंड डाइटरी सप्लीमेंट्स एंड दे हेल्प टू कीप द मेम्ब्रेन्स दैट सराउंड ऑल द सेल्स इन द बॉडी वर्किंग वेल। देयर आर 3 टाइप्स ऑफ ओमेगा 3 फैटी एसिड्स, दैट इज अल्फा लिनोलेनिक एसिड, इकोसा पेंटेनोइक एसिड एंड डोकोसा हेक्सेनोइक एसिड। Alpha linolenic acid, also known as ALA, is mostly present in plant oils such as chia seeds, flax seeds, and walnuts. And DHA is a docosahexaenoic acid, and EPA is a eicosapentaenoic acid. They are mostly present in the cold water, fatty fish such as mackerel, salmon, herring, and sardines. A person's body can convert small amount of ALA into DHA and EPA. According to the Office of Dietary Supplements, most people in the United States get enough ALA in their diet, and experts have not established how much DHA and EPA a person needs. Then benefits are the beyond the basic maintenance of cells in a person's body. Initial research has linked omega-3 fatty acids with various other health benefits. However, a lot of the research that demonstrates these links is in the early stages or relies on experiments on animals. In general, until scientists conduct further research, it is not clear to what extent omega-3 fatty acids benefit a person beyond the basic maintenance of their body's cell. The ODS note that studies have found that people who eat fish, which is a key source of omega-3 fatty acids, typically have a lower risk of various long-term illnesses compared with that who do not eat fish. However, it is not clear whether this is because of the omega-3s that the fish contain or something else. Furthermore, if it is because of the omega-3 that fish contain, it is not clear if a person taking omega-3 supplements will have the same benefits. And it may reduce omega-3 fatty acids reduces inflammation. According to the British Journal of Clinical Pharmacology, research has shown DHA and EPA to reduce the process of inflammation, which has links to various cardiovascular illnesses. However, while these effects were evident in animal studies, clinical trials on humans were less conclusive. People with rheumatoid arthritis appear to benefit from taking fish oil supplements, but there were no clear benefit for people with inflammatory bowel disease or asthma. And it may reduce the chance of heart attack. According to the ODS, there is some evidence that taking omega-3 supplements may reduce the risk of a person having a heart attack. Then, however, ODS note that other studies did not find a link between the omega-3 supplements and a less chance of person having cardiovascular issues in general. According to the NCCIH, that is National Center for Complementary and Integrative Health, researchers have shown omega-3 to help lower a person's triglyceride levels. Triglycerides are the fats, and if a person has an excess of these, they are more at risk of cardiovascular diseases. Then may help to combat the obesity. An article of the Journal of Nutritional Biochemistry states that the research in humans is yet to show omega-3 supplements to help a person lose weight, and they may be able to help a person stop putting weight back on. However, although it is not clear precisely how they may do this, and it may contribute to infant health. The NCCIH highlight a study that shows that the children of mothers who took a high dose fish oil supplement were less likely to develop asthma than the children of mothers who took a placebo. However, the NCCIH also note that other studies contradict this finding. According to the NCCIH, the side effects from omega-3 supplements are usually mild and might include the bad breath, bad smelling sweat, headaches, heartburn, nausea, and diarrhea. The ODS note that if a person is taking anticoagulants, which are drugs that stop their blood from clotting, and taking high doses of omega-3 supplements may lead to the bleeding problem. Summary is, omega-3 fatty acids are an important part of the person's nutrition and contribute to the basic health of all the cells in the body. Most people get enough omega-3 fatty acids in their diet to achieve this. A key source of omega-3 fatty acids is fish. There is a clear evidence that eating more fish can help to reduce the chances of a person developing cardiovascular illnesses. However, there has a yet to be conclusive evidence that taking omega-3 supplements has a similar health benefits. Hope you all are satisfied with this session. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, Jaipur. If you have any query, please mention it in a comment box. I will resolve them whenever we have a live session. Thank you so much for watching this.